Pickle Minute, sponsored by Avera.
Eating healthier, dropping a few pounds, just getting up and moving. It's the advice that we've heard from doctors for years. But for a lot of people, that is easier said than done.
Sam Wright spoke with Dr. David Basel about the little steps that could make big improvements in your long-term health.
Dr. Basel, diet, maintaining weight and exercise, that's easier said than done. But why are these so important for our overall health?
Yeah, this is a great subject for this time of year. We're getting past the New Year's resolution stage, and things are maybe starting to show at least some signs of getting a little bit warmer, and so time to think about this. And, you know, diet and exercise and maintaining a healthy weight are so key to so many different processes. You know, general wellness and feelings of well-being are probably the most important. It's amazing how much exercise reduces feelings of stress and burden, help with seasonal affective type of feelings. But then, you know, the things that everybody knows, you know, heart disease, stroke, diabetes, but also cancer risk is much higher with low levels of exercise, poor diet, and increased weight. Start small and make short-term achievable goals. And they can be pretty simple. Things like, I want to cut soda pop out of my diet, or I'm not going to eat after 8 p.m., or I'm not going to bring a bag of chips downstairs to watch television. It can also be on the exercise, start small and achievable. I'm going to try to get 6,000 steps in a day, or I'm going to try to walk 4 blocks in a day, and then next month increase that. Maybe I'll go 8,000 steps or go a little bit farther on my walks. And it's amazing, you know, you think about exercise doesn't just mean going out and going for a run. Brisk walking is as good from a exercise well-being as doing, you know, moderate to high intensity exercise. And so it's a good place to start.
For more information, you can head over to avera.org/medicalminute.